August 2016, an unknown assailant shot and killed 25-year-old Jeffrey Holland. His mother says several people saw what happened and could help detectives find the killer.
I've been saying stuff to him on Facebook. I've been posting, please, they need to come forward.
This year alone, nearly 60% of Indianapolis homicide cases remain open with no suspects. In at least some of those cases, concerned clergy in Indianapolis say witnesses are scared to speak up.
If they're not going to go to court and help the prosecutor out, we're going to get stuck, and now we have unsolved murders.
Indianapolis has not previously had much of a witness protection program. City leaders say just a small, rarely used grant. Today, though, Mayor Hogsett announced the availability of $300,000 to be used to better protect key witnesses to violent crimes. He says the money will not impact the city budget. It will now be up to the City County Council to evaluate specific plans.
I'm pleased that counselors on both sides have now kind of coming out, and now the mayor has come out and said we need to try to do something. I don't know that this is the end-all, be-all witness protection program, but I think it's definitely a place to start.
City leaders and parents like Michelle hope it will be enough to loosen lips and break any perceived code of silence.
I mean, my son lost his life for nothing, and now I'm thinking, nobody's going to have to pay for it.
Chance Walser, RTV6.
Marion County Prosecutor Terry Curry responded to the announcement by saying, in part, "We were pleasantly surprised by today's announcement that money has been found in the budget for assisting witnesses. We look forward to working with IMPD and other public safety partners to find effective uses of this potential funding once more details are available."